In the last lecture, we have seen the structure of envelope in prokaryotic cell. Let's to summarize the things. We have already seen an envelope of prokaryotic cell. It consists of three tightly bound layer. The first layer is glycocalyx. The second layer is cell wall. And the third layer is cell membrane. Now, just to recall the previous lecture, we just summarize the thing and try to draw a diagram for the envelope of prokaryotic cell. पिछले लेक्चर को समराइज करने के लिए हमने जो कुछ भी पिछले लेक्चर में सीखा है हम उसकी डायग्राम बनाने की कोशिश करेंगे और हम देखेंगे कि एक टिपिकल प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल किस तरह का एनवेलप रखता है. सो फॉर ड्रॉइंग द डायग्राम फर्स्टली वी विल ड्रॉ अ सेल वॉल. सो दिस लेयर वी कंसिडर एज सेल वॉल. As we have already discussed, this cell wall is a rigid structure. It is made up of peptidoglycans and murines. Okay, this cell wall is surrounded. Okay, let me draw a brick-like structure so that you can visualize it like a wall. Particular structure is cell wall. This cell wall is surrounded by a layer of glycocalyx. So this will be surrounded with the layer of glycocalyx, and it will be throughout the cell. We are drawing it only in one particular portion, but it will surround the cell totally like this. So we are drawing it in only one part. Depending upon the thickness of glycocalyx, it can be called as slime layer or capsule. Let's say here the thickness of glycocalyx is more. So here the thickness is less, so it is called as slime layer, and here the thickness is more, so it is called as capsule. So a outermost layer, this much of layer is called as glycocalyx. This is the second layer. The middle layer is called as cell wall. Now the third layer is that of cell membrane. This cell membrane is present inside the cell wall and is a continuous structure which invaginates बोले तो अंदर जाना cytoplasm के. So cell membrane is a continuous structure which invaginates into cytoplasm in the form of vesicle. So this type of structure is called as vesicle, or it can invaginate in the form of tubule, or it can invaginate in the form of lamella. So such type of structure is called as lamellated structure. By doing so, the cell membrane will increase the surface area of itself. So it will invaginate the cytoplasm at so many places. And this whole thing now, along with the cell membrane, is termed as envelope. So, are you clear for this thing? The envelope of a prokaryotic cell is consist of three tightly bound layers, where the outermost layer is glycocalyx. Depending on the thickness, if the thickness is less, then it is called a slime layer. If the thickness is more, then it is called as capsule. Then the middle layer is cell wall, which is made up of peptidoglycans, and then the innermost layer is cell membrane, which is a continuous structure, but it invaginates the cytoplasm in the form of vesicles or vacuoles or lamella. Clear for this thing? Okay. Then, now the next half of the lecture is we have to learn the modifications of this envelope. There are certain structures which protrude out of this envelope to give rise to certain hair-like or tube-like projections, which we have to learn in the next video. Okay, so we'll come back. In this video, we will try to learn about the modifications of cell envelope. As we have discussed already, the cell envelope is made up of tightly bound three layers, where the outermost layer is glycocalyx, the middle one is cell wall, and the innermost is cell membrane. Now, when this envelope will get modified, ये envelope जब modify होगा, तो इसमें से कुछ structures project होके बाहर निकलेंगे. There are certain projections which are termed as outgrowth, which will protrude out of the surface. These outgrowths are called as cellular appendages. So we are having three types of cellular appendages, in which the first one is flagella. This is plural. If single, then it is called as flagellum. A flagellum is long, hair-like extension protruding out of the cell envelope. So, a flagellum is a long, hair-like structure which is protruding out of the cell surface. This flagellum is consists of three parts. Number one, we are having a base piece, this much part of flagella is called as base piece, and it is made up of four rings, L, P, S and M. Okay? All the four rings are present in case of gram negative bacteria, while in case of gram positive bacteria, there are only two rings, that is S and M. What are the gram negative and gram positive bacteria? We have already discussed in previous videos. Okay? So, ये जो इतना पार्ट है बैक्टीरिया के फ्लैजेलम का, इसको हम बोलते हैं बेस पीस, और बेस पीस में चार रिंग्स होती है, L, P, S, M. चारों की चारों रिंग प्रेजेंट होती है ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया में, और अगर ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया है तो सिर्फ S और M रिंग ही प्रेजेंट रहेगी. द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज अ हुक. This much part of the flagella is called as hook. Okay, and attached to this hook is a long thread-like structure, which is called as filament. This filament is made up of a protein, flagelline. This is very important in situ, because a flagellar structure of prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell is different. Flagella का structure जो prokaryotic cell में है और जो eukaryotic cell में है वो अलग-अलग है. Eukaryotic cell की जो flagella है, that will show you 9+2 arrangement, and a filament of that flagella is consists of a protein tubulin. While in case of prokaryotic cell, a filament is consists of a protein flagellin and it will not have the 9+2 structure. ये 9+2 structure क्या होता है? Structure is absent. Okay? ये 9+2 structure क्या होता है? ये हम अगले videos में देखेंगे. Clear? So this is the first appendage, that is flagella. Flagella is long, hair-like structure. Clear? And the function of flagella is to perform locomotion. Flagella का function क्या है? तो if a bacteria is having a flagella, then flagella will help the bacteria for locomotion. Such type of bacteria are generally a motile bacteria. We already discussed कि depending upon the motility, there are two types of bacteria. जो movement कर सकते हैं, उनको हम motile बोलते हैं, और जिनको जो movement नहीं करते, उनको हम non-motile बोलते हैं. So this is a structure which will help the bacteria for locomotion. Now, flagella कितनी है? इसके ऊपर से भी बैक्टीरिया को हम क्लासिफाई कर सकते हैं. जस्ट यू हैव टू कंसंट्रेट ऑन द वर्ड्स. अगर आप वर्ड्स पे ध्यान दोगे तो आपको समझ में आ जाएगा कि कैसे क्लासिफाई करना है. अगर हमको बोलना है कि फ्लैजेला नहीं है, एक भी फ्लैजेला बैक्टीरिया के पास नहीं है, देन सच टाइप ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इज कॉल्ड एज अ ट्राइकस. ट्राइकस मींस फ्लैजेला, ए बोले तो अब्सेंट. So a bacteria without flagella is called as a trichus bacteria. अगर हमको ऐसा बोलना है कि bacteria के पास एक ही flagella है, so एक को शब्द क्या है? Mono. So such type of bacteria is called as monotrichus. Okay? So here is the bacteria which is not having any flagella. Here is the bacteria which is having only a single flagella. Okay? Then if you want to say कि bacteria के पास दो flagella है और दो sides से है, in that case we have to use the word on both side, we have to say, that's why we are using the word amphitrichus. Okay, so this is a bacteria which is having flagella on the both side. Clear? Now in case if a bacteria is having flagella from all the sides, सारे साइड से उसको फ्लैजेला है, तो सारे अराउंड को शब्द क्या है? पेरिफेरी, दैट इज पेरी ट्राइकस. सो पेरी ट्राइकस इज अ बैक्टीरिया विच इज हैविंग फ्लैजेला फ्रॉम ऑल द साइड. फॉर एग्जांपल साल्मोनेला टाइफी. ओके, so such type of bacteria will have flagella from all sides. So depending ki flagella ka number kitna hai aur kahan pe present hai, we can again classify the bacteria. Clear? Then the next appendage of bacteria is fimbriae. Fimbria. Clear? Fimbria are small hair like structure. See, flagella is long hair-like structure. Fimbria are small hair-like structure. They are like a bristles of toothbrush, and they will protrude from all the side of bacteria. So we have drawn a type of flagella here. Now we have said that fimbria are the small hair-like structure which will protrude out from all the side of bacteria. They are like bristles of toothbrush. So after drawing the fimbria, the bacterial cell will look like this. So they are small hair-like extensions which are protruding out of the surface like a bristles of toothbrush. Clear for this thing? Okay. This fimbria will help the bacteria to adhere to any surface. The word used by NCERT is the clinging. So help the bacteria in clinging. Clinging के लिए, चिटकने के लिए, adhere करने के लिए किसी भी surface से these particular processes are useful. Then a third appendage which is present as an outgrowth from the bacterial surface is pili, or we can simply call it as pili. Pili's are long tube-like structure. So pili's are long tube-like structure. This structure will look like a tube which is protruding out of the surface. This is a hollow structure like this. Okay, so what you have said, if flagella is long hair-like structure, fimbria is small hair-like structure, but the pili are long tube-like structure. This pili or tube-like structure is useful for conjugation. What is conjugation? It is a parasexual reproduction. So these tube-like structures are useful for the process of conjugation. So conjugation ki process kya hai? Conjugation is a type of parasexual reproduction in which one particular bacteria will give its extra genetic material to another bacteria with the help of this tube-like process. Suppose this is one particular bacteria and it is having this extra chromosomal part, that is plasmid, and this is another bacteria which is not having this plasmid. Then such type of bacteria is called as plus strain of bacteria, and it is not having the plasmid. This structure is plasmid. We'll discuss about the plasmid in the next video. Okay, and this particular plasmid, and this particular bacteria is not having the plasmid. So this type of bacteria is called as negative strain bacteria. So what happens if this bacteria wants to give this plasmid to this bacteria? So for transforming this genetic material, it will protrude a tube which make a connection between this bacteria, and through this tube, this plasmid will come from this bacteria, positive bacteria, to negative bacteria. It is a process of conjugation. This particular process we will learn in the 12th standard. This particular process will help us to transform the bacteria from one type of bacteria into another type of bacteria. This process is conjugation, and the conjugation will help in transformation of bacteria. So this bacteria which have now got a new plasmid or a new set of gene is called as transformed bacteria. Clear for this thing? In the next part, we will deal with the cytoplasm and its content.